morning, boys. This is your economics class. Since today is the first class, I'm giving you just an outline of the syllabus that we are going to cover. And on the basis of that, we will proceed in the next classes. Now, first of all, regarding the syllabus, total economics syllabus is of 80 marks, 20 marks project. That is 80 plus 20, 100. Now, these 80 marks is divided into certain groups. The basic groups are economic theory, that we have to study. Then we will go to Indian economics. And the last part will be statistics. The total 3 parts are there, and some of that will be 80. First, we will start with that, and as the time goes on, we will discuss regarding Indian economics and statistics. Clear? Now, basically, your paper will be of 80 marks, theoretical paper, and 20 marks will be project. Any discussion relating to your project will not be discussed nowadays, it will be discussed later on. Your 80 marks paper, that will be divided into certain number of questions. Let me also explain that. First, you will get some MCQ question, multiple choice questions. That 1 marks question, MCQ question, that will be of 10. 10 MCQ questions will be there. Then, 1 marks objective type question will be there. That is also of 10 marks. 10. 10 MCQ, 10 1 marks question. Then we will face 2 marks questions of 10. And then you have 5 marks questions, 6. And 1 10 marks question will be there. This is your classification of questions. First we will get MCQ 1 marks question number 10. Then 1 marks objective type question 10. Then 2 marks question 10, 5 marks question 6, and 1 10 marks question. Total it will be 80. Now, I will start today with the first chapter of economic theory, that is the first chapter of your syllabus also. That chapter number 1 is scope of economics and definition of economics. Regarding this chapter and regarding all the chapters I am doing, I will do with you. One thing must be clear, you can consult any book of economics that has been prescribed in your book list. But when you are sitting in front of the camera for these classes, please take one copy and pen, whatever I am telling today, whatever I will tell in my future classes, please write them down on the copy. It will be easier for you to understand. So everyone, I will expect, is sitting with the copy and pen. What I am trying to say, you please write it down. The first chapter, I am starting with chapter 1. That is economic definition and scope of economics. The first thing we will start with is, what is economics all about? There are so many students who are studying economics first time. For them, it is very much necessary to know what is economics all about. Now, economics always deals with certain problems relating to scarcity and choice. In this regard, obviously, these two new terms are there. Scarcity, one is scarcity and another is choice. We should clarify these two words, what is scarcity, what is choice. Now see, boys, if you look at your daily life, then you can see we use so many types of goods and services. Now, I need all those goods and services. So, these are my want. I need toothpaste, I need toothbrush, need soap, I need coffee, I need pen, I need pencils, I need food, I need clothes, I need so many things. This is my want. This is the want. But the point is, want is unlimited. There is no limit of our want. But the problem at the same time, all my wants can't be fulfilled. That is the problem, because all the resources in the economy are not unlimited. So human wants are unlimited, but the resources are not. And that creates a scarcity problem. Scarcity, the word scarcity implies lack of supply relative to demand. I need so many things, but the resources in the economy do not allow me to fulfill all my wants. That's the meaning of scarcity. There is always a scarcity of resources in the economy. Now, since the scarcity is there, obviously, we have to make a choice. For example, I need commodities A, B, C, D. For example, this is my want. I need A, I need B, I need C, I need D, etc. But the resources of the economy do not permit me, do not permit the producers rather to produce all these A, B, C, D. Or my income does not permit me to use all those things. As a result of that, the consumers, we make a choice. That's why the term choice comes. The choice tells me that I can consume only A and B. C, D are not produced. It is not possible to produce. This is the meaning of scarcity, and because of that, this is choice. Scarcity is there, that's my choice comes. Today, after this, we will continue in the next class.